Hi, I'm Guy from Scoop. Configurations of MikroTik devices can seem daunting to anybody just starting out. However, MikroTik commands a strong global market share precisely because of the granular control you can exercise. The tech community loves their creative approach to finding different ways of doing things. If you're new to MikroTik, we'll help you overcome these initial hurdles and welcome you into a world of networking possibilities. Welcome to this chapter of our MikroTik Back to Basics video series. We'll start with a very simple Wi-Fi 5 access point setup. Keep in mind that you can explore other approaches to doing this, but our focus at this Back to Basics level is aimed at first-time users. We'll work towards more advanced configurations in due course. Let's take an out-of-the-box device that has no configuration applied to it at all. To get to this state, click the Remove Configuration button when first logging into the device. For this example, we're using the trusty HAP AC2. On the software side, we'll be using the latest version of MikroTik's Winbox to log into this device. At this time, we're using version 4.0 beta 12. When logging into your Wi-Fi 5 or AC device, ensure that you log in via the MAC address by clicking on that item. We do this because there hasn't been any IP address assigned yet, and also so that any changes made to the IP won't disconnect you each time. Once logged in, start by navigating to the Bridge option and add a new bridge. Now go to the Ports tab. Here we need to add each of the interfaces that we'd like included into the bridge we've just created. In doing so, all the interfaces can communicate with one another freely. Next, we want to give the device an IP address. This can be done automatically or manually. For the automatic option, navigate to IP, DHCP client, then add a new interface while specifying the bridge interface under the DHCP header. Now plug the device into the network and the bridge will get an IP assigned to it automatically. Done. To set a static IP, navigate to IP, addresses, and add one. In the address box, we'll use 192.168.24.10/24. Since that's part of the range that our main network is handing out. Make sure to specify the subnet, /24, so that the interface knows which network IP to use. Now select the bridge as the interface that this IP applies to, and click OK. Something to note, the wireless settings on MikroTik AC devices are configured a little differently to the Wi-Fi on MikroTik's AX devices. We'll cover this difference in the next video. Cool, back to our AC setup. Now we can start the wireless configuration. On your Wi-Fi 5 device, head to the Wireless option. In the window, you'll notice that the interfaces are grayed out, indicating that they're disabled. We'll only configure the 5 GHz interface in this demo, but the method is identical for 2.4 GHz, and you can do both to complete your setup. Double-click the WLAN 2 interface to open the window. Tick the Enabled checkbox. Name the interface something logical for easy identification. For us, we'll use 5 GHz. In the wireless section, the mode is set to AP Bridge. For band, we selected the 5 GHz A, N, AC option for comprehensive device compatibility. Channel width is set to 20, 40, 80 MHz for the best possible throughput. We'll set our frequency to 5250 MHz, but you can use any frequency within the permitted range. Our SSID is set to HAP AC2-5GHz, so we know what to connect to once our config is completed. Leave security as default because this will be changed shortly. Set the country to where you are so that your device abides by the country's regulatory ranges and power limits. Now you can click OK. The last change to make is the password for your wireless connection, because until you've done so, your network will remain open. Head to the Security tab in the Wireless Tables window and double-click the default profile to edit it. Expand the drop-down menu by mode and select Dynamic Keys. For compatibility's sake, we'll select both WPA and WPA2 as authentication types. In the pre-shared key sections are where you'll input the wireless passwords. We don't need to worry about any of the other options here right now, so click OK. Because we didn't change the security profile in the previous section, we can count on these passwords to be applied automatically to the wireless interface. You now have a functioning Wi-Fi 5 access point with DHCP pass-through, and your device is ready for wireless access and further configuration. Any client devices connecting to the bridged Ethernet ports or wireless interfaces will be able to access the rest of your network. Please like and subscribe, and catch us in the following videos where we'll look at setting up AX devices, a basic router, and a simple yet effective firewall, just to get us started. Thanks for watching, I'm Guy from Scoop.